Hi, and greetings from Mount Everest. I'm Heather Forbes, and we are on day two of my reading of Classroom 180. So I chose this location of Mount Everest to symbolize the need for all of us to still be on top of the world, no matter what. You know, this is a very, very hard situation. So many things are out of our control, but I think it's still a lesson in knowing that love is still available, happiness is still available. And so with a little discipline, a little focus, and a little letting go, we can still find our way to the top of the world. So we left off on page 18. The trauma-informed movement provides this broader perspective. It is a movement based on the need for children to be in strong and loving relationships, not only from their families, but also from their schools. This concept also follows the growing field of human social neuroscience. It stresses the importance of social interactions for mental health. Additionally, brain science is explicitly showing that when children and adults are connected and feeling emotionally secure, they can think more clearly, their memory systems are intact, and most importantly, their love for learning is back online. Relationships are thus at the heart of the trauma-informed movement, and it is within the classroom that the strongest relationships are developed. When the classroom becomes more than purely a place to expand a child's intellect, but also offers relationships to provide the whole child's development, everyone wins. It takes expanding our perspective to see the school classroom more like a family, a place where every student is accepted and supported unconditionally. When we create classrooms to function as a family and we support the needs of students from a holistic perspective, as a healthy family would, children want to come to school. See figure 1.3. They want to learn, and they are more neurologically equipped to do so. They feel accepted, loved, and validated. Not only do they feel like they belong, they know they belong to something bigger than themselves. They have a place in this world. They develop a greater sense of empathy for themselves and for those around them. And ultimately, academics test scores increase as well. This concept of the classroom becoming the family is especially significant for students impacted by trauma, because one of the biggest fallouts from trauma is rejection and abandonment. Nothing can ever replace a child's family, but school is the next line of contact with children, so it can have a powerful and healing impact on them. Belonging is a fundamental need for every child, and it is essential to every child's overall well-being, especially our billies, who are typically missing this dynamic. When creating a trauma-informed classroom, the following relationship-based components need to be developed. 1, family culture. 2, teacher-student relationships. 3, student-to-student relationships. And 4, teacher-to-parent relationships. Right, tune in tomorrow for the next reading.